Michelle Malkin's here. Michelle, you're watching the drama, and did you watch any of the press conference in the homeland of Gretchen and Steve, Sweden, yesterday? Your impression of the president talking about the red line?
Yeah, well, he looks nervous, and he should look nervous, because after coming off of throwing the U.S. and an entire branch of government, our Congress, under the bus on a world stage, there really isn't much left for him in terms of ground to stand on. And a lot of people wish he wouldn't come back after that performance. He really is a pathological buck passer. And I think the soundbite from Donald Rumsfeld really says it all. And boy, do we miss adults like Donald Rumsfeld in Washington right about now. The unprecedented amount of fecklessness and recklessness that's been shown by this White House is really not going to help him in those frosty negotiations and discussions.
So was that a way, Michelle, to try and put Congress on notice that look, the red line doesn't stop with me, the buck doesn't stop with me, the buck stops with you, so you better get in line and vote in favor of this attack? Is that how you interpreted it?
Well, I don't know what the heck that was, Gretchen, because after spending the last week, 2 weeks, dismissing the idea that Congress should play any role at all, he now turns around and says that it's their credibility on the line. This is crazy. And, you know, we all know from Government 101 that politicians are supposed to take credit and diffuse blame. But the massive amount of appropriation of credit for other people's successes compared to the congenital redistribution of blame for his own failures, it really is remarkable.
Well, you know, it all started with a mistake. The line about the red line last year, he just ad-libbed that. And he's been trying to dig himself out from it ever since. And then extraordinarily yesterday, essentially, he said, not my red line, not my credibility, not my fault.
Yeah, well, it would be funny, the perils of the teleprompter president, if there weren't American lives at risk.
That's right.
And that's what makes this such a dark farce.
Amen. How about this story? There are a number of prominent universities, including Yale, Brown, and Penn State. And what they're going to do is they're going to offer college kids credit if they try to update Wikipedia to include more feminist thinking into Wikipedia entries. They feel that there just isn't enough of that angle in Wikipedia right now.
Right, because there already isn't an overload of left-wing bias and social justice rewriting of historical narratives on Wikipedia. Well, you know, this was a great story by Ben Shapiro and Front Page Magazine, who were on the front lines of trying to make sure that the right has enough space and place in social media. And as much as we can make fun of Wikipedia, the fact is that there are millions of people around the world, and yes, some really lazy people in the news business who rely primarily on it. I know that there have been people on other networks who've been caught reading verbatim from Wikipedia as news and facts. Hello? But the fact is that we do need to be fighting in these spaces, and what the left is doing is a rather savvy thing, because they know he who writes history controls the world.
Wow. That's scary, considering that one day somebody went into our Wikipedia accounts and made Steve a stripper.
From Indiana.
Yes.
And what were you doing, Brian? I forget what Brian was.
But I think I was dead. Yeah. They killed me.
Yeah, there you go.
I've got many Wikipedia war stories myself, and my favorite one that I've told my kids is when they claim that I was 4 feet tall. Not true.
I feel for you, Michelle.
You are
I feel for you.
5 feet tall.
and if you want to know a good sight, it's Twitchy.
Twitchy is very good.
Thank you.
Meanwhile,
That's
we
right.
would encourage our viewers right now, go into our Wikipedia.
Oh, no.
It just goes to show you how corrupt it can be. All right, Michelle Malkin.
All right, change him. Entertain us for the last 45 minutes. We'll find out.
That's right.
Oh my gosh.
All right. Thanks, Michelle.